Hello students, welcome to EPG Paathshala. I am Dr. Vishal from Maharaja Agarsen University, Badi, Himachal Pradesh. Today, we are going to discuss about the module, The Coastal Areas of India, under the paper, Tourism Products of India. Students, after completing this module, you will be able to understand about the coastal areas of India, understand the significance of coastline, coast, coastal plains and ghats, and also know about the popular beaches of India. A coastal region can be divided into four parts: the coastline, the coast, the coastal plains, the ghats. A coastal line is defined as the line that forms the boundary between the land and the ocean, or the outline of a coast. Coastline is the narrow strip of land that forms the border of the sea alongside a continent or a lake. The waves are forever in motion and make sure that the reshaping of cliffs, bays, beaches, lagoons, bar, etc. is always in progress, sometimes in a huge scoop and sometimes one sand grain at a time. But one thing that is constant at the coastline is change. According to the National Geographic Society, the coast is the land along a sea. The boundary of a coast where land meets water is called the coastline. Waves, tides and current help create coastlines. When waves crash into shore, they wear away at or erode the land. A coastal plain is a flat, low-lying piece of land next to the ocean. Coastal plains are separated from the rest of the interior by nearby landforms such as mountains. Coastal plains are formed by two methods. Some initiate as a continental shelf, that is an underwater chunk of land which is below the level of the sea and is flat piece or relatively leveled. In the due course of as and when the ocean levels falls, the underlying land is revealed, thus forming a coastal plain. Coastal plains also form when river currents bring in rock, soil and other sediment into the ocean. As this material starts to deposit, layers of this sedimentary material build up over time. This forms a leveled or a slightly inclined or titled landscape. According to Britannica, ghats are two mountain ranges forming the eastern and western edges respectively of the Deccan Plateau of Peninsular India. The two ranges run roughly parallel to the Bay of Bengal and Arabian Sea coast respectively, from which they are separated by strips of fairly level coastal land. In Hindi, ghat means river landing stairs or mountain pass and has been extended in its anglicized plural form to include the mountains themselves. Coastal region. This meeting of the land and ocean results in an exclusive environment where marine terrestrial environment influence each other. Coastline is the narrow strip where coastal waters and land come in contact with each other. Waves, tides and currents helps in creating coastlines. This is done through constant erosion that take place. The speed of erosion depends on the material that the land is made up of and the material that the water brings with it. For example, the coastal area of Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, mostly comprises of hard materials like quartz and granite. Therefore, the landforms have hardly experienced an erosion and still appear to the same as centuries ago. Whereas the famous White Cliffs of Dover, England, comprise of a much softer material, that is calcium carbonate, thus is getting eroded at a much faster pace. As coasts are dynamic landforms, they are extremely delicate and important ecosystems. They are home to innumerable variety of aquatic and terrestrial flora and fauna. Coasts help us in understanding many weather and natural phenomena. They are fragile biomes that are unique and mysterious in their splendor. Let's discuss the types of coastlines. Coastline of emergence, coastline of submergence, coastline of emergence. This type of coastline is either the result of uplifting of the land or the lowering of the sea level. Aquatic landforms, for example, lagoons, bars, beaches, arches, spits and salt marshes are all classic features of emergent coastline. The Coromandel Coast and the Malabar Coasts are coastlines of emergence. Coastline of submergence. This type of coastline is either the result of submergence, mostly due to faulting of the land or the rising of the sea level. The Konkan Coast is an example of coastline of submergence. Formation of coastal regions, classification and characteristics. There are various classification schemes, but is generally either primary coast. These are coast generally young and are formed and shaped by terrestrial activities including river, stream disposition, erosion, volcanism, tectonic and glacier movements. Secondary coasts. These coasts are generally older and are formed and shaped mostly by marine erosion or deposition due to wave action, sediment get transported by currents or activities of certain organisms. Erosional coasts. These coasts develop where the active wave action causes erosion or erosion occurs through rivers or glaciers when sea level was lower than its presently level. These include cliffs or rocky shores. Depositional coasts. These depositional coasts develop where accumulation of sediments takes place either through a local source or after being brought along to the area by rivers and glaciers or by ocean currents and waves. These include mangrove swamps, barrier islands, deltas, salt marshes and beach sand dunes. Volcanic coasts. These coasts are formed by the volcanic activity. The lava flow gets hardened over a period of time and gradually gets weathered by waves. These coastal landforms are formed either by volcanic explosion or collapsing of a volcano. Fault coasts. These coasts are formed by the warping and faulting of the crust. That is, a side of the fault moves high up in comparison to other side and the sea water fills up this gap. Indian coastline. The Indian coastline of about 7,516.6 km includes 5,422.6 km of mainland and 2,094 km of coastline belonging to Indian islands. The major ones being the Andaman and Nicobar Islands in the Bay of Bengal and the Lakshadweep Islands in the Arabian Sea. The coastline touches 13 states and union territories of India. India has a comparatively unswerving and consistent coastline with not many sites for natural harbors of good quality. It is believed that the origin of the Indian coastline was the faulting, or in other words, the continental drift of the Gondwanaland during the Cretaceous period. The Bay of Bengal and the Arabian Sea also came into existence during the Cretaceous or earlier Tertiary period after the disintegration of Gondwanaland. The Indian coastline comprises the states of Gujarat, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Odisha, and West Bengal. The cities in the coastline of India are notable for trading through ships from international as well as domestic coastal cities. Apart from the big port cities, the coasts are also dotted with small yet beautiful towns and villages that have beautiful beaches and quaint ways of life that are major tourist attractions. Eastern coast of India. The eastern coast is situated in the middle of the Eastern Ghats and the Bay of Bengal. It stretches from the Sundarbans Delta to the southern tip of the Indian mainland, Kanyakumari. It is dotted with various deltas, for example, those of the Mahanadi, the Godavari, the Krishna, and the Kaveri. The lagoon in the Pulicat Lake and the Chilka Lake are important geographical landmarks of the East Coast. The Eastern Coast has regional names by which they are more popular locally. That is, Odisha Coast is locally known as the Utkal Coast. South of the Utkal lies the Andhra Coast, and the south to the Andhra lies the Tamil Nadu Coast. The southern part of the Andhra Coast and the Tamil Nadu together are called the Coromandel Coast. East Coastal Plain. The coastal plains commence in the north with the Suvarnarekha River and stretches to Kanyakumari in the south. The plains lie between the eastern coastline bordered by the Bay of Bengal in the east and to the west are the Eastern Ghat Hills. The East Coastal Plains extended for about 1500 km. In comparison to the Western Plains, the Eastern Coastal Plains are wider. The fertile plains are known as the Granary of the South, as nearly a quarter of the Eastern Coastal Plain area is a part of the Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna, and Kaveri deltas. The Eastern Coastal Plain is dotted with a number of sand dune lagoons that are enclosed between the sand dunes and the coast. These are slightly bridged to the bay, that is Chilka Lake in the Utkal Coast, Kolleru and Pulicat Lakes in the Andhra Coast. The island of Sriharikota, which is the satellite and rocket launching hub. The Space Research Center of India is situated in the Pulicat Lake. West Coast of India. The Western Coast is situated in the middle of the Western Ghats and the Arabian Sea. It extends from the Gulf of Combay in the northern to Cape Comorin in the south. The coasts are rich in alluvium brought by the streams that are originate in the Western Ghats. There are a number of small bays, estuaries, and creeks in the West Coast. The Kerala Coast is dotted with geographical features like lakes, lagoons, and backwaters, the largest being the Vembanad Lake. The Western Coast has regional names by which they are more popular locally. For example, the Maharashtra and the Goa Coast are known as the Konkan Coast, and the Karnataka and the Kerala Coast are known as the Malabar Coast. West Coastal Plain. The north to south extension of the Western Coastal Plain is from the white salt desert of Kutch to Kanyakumari respectively. To the east of the plains are the Western Ghats, and to the west is the clear blue Arabian Sea. The west coastal plains are comparatively narrower than the eastern coastal plains. The plains get narrower as they proceed to the south. And unlike the eastern plains, the rivers that originate in the Western Ghats hills do not form deltas while draining into the Arabian Sea. The west coastal plains are very important with a view of agriculture and trade. A lot of sugarcane, spices, rice and coconut are produced in these fertile plains, and the ports of Chennai, Mumbai, Kochi, etc. are important seaports from which international trade is carried out. Let's discuss now significance of coastal regions. The coastal areas of India are extremely fertile regions and are an important source of crops like rice, exotic crops like various spices, and rich crops like dry fruits. Coconut trees grow all along the coast. These are not only fruit bearing trees but are also a source of coconut oil, coconut husk, which is also used as fuel by the locals. The coastal areas are very significant for international and domestic sea route trade. The complete length of the coast is marked with seaports of various sizes that aid and encourage trade. Mineral oil is another resource which is found in the sedimentary rocks of the coastal plains. Large deposits of mineral oil are said to be in the Krishna Godavari basin. Monazite, a reddish brown phosphate mineral containing rare earth metal, is found in fair amounts in the sands of the Kerala coast, is an important component in the generation of nuclear power. Another important occupation of coastal areas is fishing. Production of salt is prevalent in the low-lying areas of Gujarat. Coastal areas are prime tourist destination as they have spectacular variety of attractions to offer to visitors. The beaches, coral reefs, adventure activities, nature, scenic beauty are just to name a few. Most popular beaches of India. The India coastline extends to an impressive 7,516.6 km bordered by the Bay of Bengal in the east, Indian Ocean in the south, and the Arabian Sea in the west. The coastline of India has a splendor of mesmerizing beaches. The coastline is a treasure trove for tourists with their golden and white beaches. Tourists from world over flock to the exotic beaches of Goa, Kerala, Andaman and Nicobar, etc. Apart from their beauty, the beaches offer ample opportunities for adventure sports, mostly water adventure such as surfing, scuba diving, snorkeling, etc. Kelengad Beach, Goa, amongst the popular beaches of North India. It is famous for the Goan nightlife and mouth-watering seafood. The beach also offers water sports like parasailing, sailing, windsurfing, etc. And other famous beaches of Goa are Anjuna, Kolva, and Kandolamik. Kovalam Beach, Kerala. The Kovalam is unanimously considered as the most beautiful beach of Kerala and amongst the most frequented beaches of India. Kovalam is in the capital city of Trivandrum, and as its natural beauty gives you a heavenly feeling. Kovalam is a group of three beaches and stretches for about 70 km on the Arabian Sea coast. The beaches that comprise Kovalam are the Lighthouse Beach, the Hova Beach and the Samudra Beach. The popular beaches of Kerala are the Alappuzha Beach and the Mujahilipallang Beach, with Mujahilipallang being the only drive in beach in Asia. Divegar Beach, Maharashtra. This beautiful stretch of beach known as Divegar Beach is a part of the Maharashtra or Konkan coast, and it is at a distance of about 170 km from Mumbai. Located on the Mumbai-Goa highway, Divegar Beach has a dense coverage of willow trees. The Konkan coast of Maharashtra is famous for typical white sand beaches and palm trees. Marine Beach, Tamil Nadu. Marina is the hot spot of Chennai, located on the Coromandel coast. The beach stretches for about 13 km along the Bay of Bengal, making a name for itself for being the longest urban beach of the country. Puri Beach, Odisha. The Puri Beach, situated in the same city as the famous Jagannath Puri Temple, is a tourist attraction beacon. This beach is popular for sand art and the Puri Beach Festival, which is held annually. This treasure of nature is located just 35 kilometers from the famous Konark Temple and 60 kilometers from the capital city, Bhubaneswar. Radhanagar Beach, Andaman Island. The award-winning Radhanagar Beach is on the Havelock Island in the Great Andaman. It has been awarded for its quality and beauty and is ranked amongst the best beaches of Asia and is one of the must-visit beaches of India. Other nearby popular beaches are Vijayanagar Beach and Elephant Beach. Devka Beach, Daman and Diu. Located in Daman, Devka Beach is an important tourist attraction of the area. The beach offers a number of water sports and a golden sand beach with a coconut, palm and hoka trees lining the coastline. Other popular beaches of Daman and Diu are Chakratirath, Gomti Mata, Nagoa and a Pitait Sunset Point. Agathi Island Beach, Lakshadweep. The tranquil beaches of the Lakshadweep Islands are popular for their quality beaches, especially for swimming. Amongst them is the Agathi Beach, which stretches for about 5.6 km. The Coral Atoll, sparkling clear water, coral fishes and a coral reefs makes this beach a unique one. The availability of water adventure sports like scuba diving, snorkeling and kayaking is another point gainer for the beach. Promenade Beach, Pondicherry. A major attraction for the tourists in Pondicherry, the Promenade Beach is a fascinating natural sight. The road runs alongside the beach, dotted with famous landmarks like the Heritage Town Hall, duplex and statue of the Mahatma Gandhi situated along the beach. Other popular beaches of Pondicherry are Paradise Beach and the Auroville Beach. Ramakrishna Beach, Andhra Pradesh. This beach is a famous tourist attraction site of Vishakhapatnam and believed to be one of the most exotic beaches on the eastern coast. The spectacular beach is full of action with swimming, sunbathing and beach volleyball. Apart from this, the nearby aquarium museum and the Kali Temple are also must-visit sites for the tourists. Other popular beaches of Andhra Pradesh are Suryalanka and Rishikondan, etc. Digha Beach, Kolkata. The Digha Beach of Kolkata is one of the most frequented beaches of the Bay of Bengal coast. The last few years have witnessed the growing popularity of the Digha Beach, especially as an excursion or a weekend gateway destination. The other popular beaches around the Digha Beach are the New Digha, Chandaneshwar and Shankarpur. Karwar Beach, Karnataka. It is situated on the banks of the River Kali. Karwar is a good place to enjoy sun, sea and sand. The beauty of this beach has inspired many an artist. Karwar Beach is a beautiful natural tourism product, especially because of its flora and fauna and the fascinating Kali River Bridge. Other popular beaches along the Karwar are the Devbagh Beach, Kasurina Beach and Binega Beach. Database on coastal states of India. Coastal conservation, a grave thought. Ecology has been defined as the study of organism in relation to their environment. Then there is environment, which includes not only the animate organisms but also the inanimate forces operating in nature. Though ecology covers all aspects of human species, man is the center of all. Therefore, he is solely responsible for the positive as well as the negative consequences of his actions. Man progresses and nature loses is a common proverb and true to a large extent with a very few exceptions. Wherever and whenever development projects have been carried out, its first attack is on the nature. At first, natural vegetation of various endemic and rare species are chalked off. Very seldom, alternative green belts are developed. Different infrastructures are erected. Their construction leads to the disturbance of natural drainage system and leads to soil erosion. The depletion of natural vegetation deeply affects the fauna of that place. So students, let's now summarize what we have learned in this module. Coastal areas are no exception. These are environmentally fragile areas, and any kind of development in these regions can lead to drastic ecological changes and thus environmental degradation. If left to its own devices, tourism development can turn into a monster gulping down the very essence of the destination, leaving the destination high and dry in the long run. Tourism development done in such areas must be under microscopic scrutiny, and the environmental impact assessment must be the most important and crucial part of tourism planning for sustainable development. Therefore, it is of utmost importance that coastal tourism and coastal conservation go hand in hand, turn up to be the latest buddies on the block. Preparing a destination for tourism is serious business. The planning for development must initiate with the measures for conservation, preservation, and protection of the destination. Each and every action taken for tourism development must be assessed on their environmental, social, cultural, and economic impacts. The green signal should only come through for projects that come through in these assessments. Sustainable tourism should be the thumb rule for any tourism development, so that the natural as well as man-made heritage of our country can be passed on to the generations to come.